not only do you have to really know your medical terminology, but you should understand the diseases too. Okay, yes, it's not that you have to have the disease process memorized, but the reason you have to know the disease process and the signs and symptoms of things is because when you have a definitive diagnosis in physician-based coding, you don't code the signs and symptoms. So if you don't know what's the signs and sign or symptoms of that diagnosis, you might try to code it when you don't code it. Or you may not realize that it's not a sign or symptom of that diagnosis and it could be coded. This comes with time. A lot of that is basic knowledge. For instance, if you have a person that comes in and they're complaining of a cough and they're coughing up, you know, phlegm and their throat's sore, they got pain in their throat and they have a headache and they've got fever and chills and they've got a fever that's, you know, 102. So the diagnosis is upper respiratory infection. Well, upper respiratory infection causes a fever, so you can't code the fever. If you, it also causes, you know, chills and all of those symptoms, the cough and stuff like that, a persistent cough, all that's caused by a upper respiratory infection. Now, we know that. Most people know that. However, if you have somebody that comes in and they have hypertension and they've got chronic kidney disease and they've got diabetes and they come in and they're complaining of urinating frequently and their throat, you know, they've got dry mouth and they can't seem to get enough fluid in them and it hurts when they go to the bathroom and pee and all this other stuff, this pain and everything. If you don't know what are the signs and symptoms associated with the diseases that they have, meaning you know, CKD, chronic kidney disease, and diabetes and hypertension, then you may struggle. And this is not hard to learn, though, because you see it repeatedly. And you can always ask. But, yes, you do need to kind of know those disease processes. Okay, thanks. I just got hired as a coder there, and we do ICD-9 and CPT coding. We're getting ready for ICD-10. Everything is done online. Interested in getting certified in the field. I like it. You know what? That is another thing. A lot of people are doing coding, but they're not certified. And if you want to make more money, you better get certified. Your employer will appreciate it. Interested in getting certified in this field? Okay. I'm looking for pain management code mapper. Any suggestions? Google it. I don't know of one off the top of my head, but I can tell you that that is a really big niche coding market now because there are pain management clinics popping up all over the place. When I was doing some physician education for the AAPC and I was having to make some calls, and a lot of them in one area were pain management clinics. Really interesting. So I would just Google it. That's way, if I don't know where something is, I just, Lauren and I both, we're Google girls. So just Google pain management code mapper and I bet you will have stuff all over the place. If you can't find anything, put it in the forum, in the CCO forum, and we'll work at getting you a good one. If you want to also, we can talk about it next month and I can get a real specific question and I'll go and do some research for you. A lot of anesthesiologists and stuff are working in pain management.
Get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. Go to www.codingcertification.org.